In June, the U.S. had the strongest month for job growth since March. The Bureau of Labor Statistics reported that the economy added 850,000 jobs in June. That number far exceeds what economists had expected. President Biden says his American Rescue Plan is working.
The last time the economy grew at this rate was in 1984, and Ronald Reagan was telling us it's morning in America. Well, it's getting close to afternoon here. The sun is coming out. We're on the right track. Our plan is working, and we're not going to let up now.
And here now to talk about this latest jobs report from the University of San Diego, Alan Jin. Alan, good to see you tonight.
Thanks for having me.
All right, first, let me have you weigh in on the jobs report. Is it a sign that the economy is recovering?
I think it's definitely a good report. 850,000 jobs were added in June. That's the biggest one-month increase that we've seen since the recovery from the pandemic. So that is good news as far as more people then going back to work is concerned.
Does this mean this may give us momentum going into the next month? I mean, is that how it works as we start to see kind of jobs adding in? It's just going to kind of propel into the next month and grow?
I think so. I think the next few months will be pretty good because this report was completed, or the survey was completed before California reopened. I think the survey ended on June the 12th. And so because of that, we hadn't seen the impact of California's reopening on June the 15th. And so I think when the next report comes out, we'll see even better numbers.
I know that we have been seeing the biggest recovery in basically the hospitality and leisure sectors. Is that where we're continuing to see the biggest growth or at least the biggest boom?
That was the case in June. About 40% of those 850,000 jobs were in leisure and hospitality. So as restaurants start reopening and expanding their operations, as hotels get more customers, they're hiring more people. And so as a result of that, yes, we're seeing a big comeback in terms of leisure and hospitality. We're still down, though, more than 2 million jobs compared to where we were in that sector before the pandemic.
How are we seeing a difference in those states that have basically said no to the federal piggyback on the employment funds? How are we seeing trends in those states as opposed to other states that are continuing to accept that federal assistance?
I think it's too early to tell as far as that is concerned. I don't think enough data has come in yet. This report didn't break it down state by state. And so we'll have to wait a little bit longer to see the impact then on an individual state basis.
You know, I know it's summertime, so most schools would be out. But was there an impact on staffing because of, you know, schools being closed down in certain places and open? Because, I mean, we all know until the schools got fully reopened, the economy was not going to start taking on some momentum.
Yeah, that caused some childcare issues. It's interesting report because June, we usually actually see an uptick in people unemployed as school ends. So it's not that teachers are being laid off or anything like that, but it's more the support people that work with schools, things like custodians and people in the food service area. I think we're still in a situation where the education situation is being sorted out.
So what has, because I mean, we've covered this so many times, there's a supply issue, you know, if the folks are trying to get people to come back to work, what has that, let's call it a supply constraint, done to wages? And I mean, goodness, the stories about bonuses, you know, come work at a hotel and we're going to give you a $500 bonus. What has that done for overall wages?
It's given a boost to wages. So right now, workers are in a really good position. There's a shortage of workers, and so they're able to command these bonuses and higher wages as well. And interestingly, what we're seeing is a lot of people now quitting their jobs and moving on to other jobs. The quit rate, something called the quit rate, is at its highest level ever. So that is an indication that even though the unemployment rate is kind of high at near 6%, people are confident that they can quit their jobs and find other ones in the economy.
Wow. Counting your chickens before they're hatched. That's a little scary in my business. All right, Alan, thank you so much for your time tonight and your insight. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, and have a good 4th of July weekend.
You too. Happy 4th of July.